Hi, welcome back. So in this video, we shall discuss electric dipole and electric dipole moment. So first, let us see what is the definition of electric dipole moment. So two equal and opposite charges separated by a very small distance constitute a dipole. So if you are having two equal charges, okay, two charges which are equal and they're separated by a very small distance, if the separation between the two charges is very small, then it will have a dipole. It will constitute a dipole. Okay, suppose I'm considering here a negative charges, equal and opposite. So this charge is negative, and here I'm considering another charge to be, at this point, I'm considering another charge to be, just a second. At this point, I'm considering another charge plus Q. This is Q, this is also Q. One is minus, one is plus. Opposite charges, equal and opposite charges. Okay. So now they are separated by a very small distance. Okay, then they will have a dipole. It will constitute a dipole. So when you are discussing about dipole, you need to know about two terms. The first one is the axial line, and the second one is equatorial line. Okay, you need to know, because later on we will find out the electric field intensity at the axial line, okay, of the dipole, then equatorial line of the dipole for those things. So now if you see here, if I take any line along this distance, okay, along this distance, then this line is said to be axial line. And if I take any line perpendicular, okay, from the center of the dipole, suppose this is the center of the dipole. If I take any line from the center of the dipole, okay, perpendicular and passing to the center, then that is said to be as equatorial line. So these are the two very important terms that we need to know. Clear? Now we will see electric dipole moment. What is electric dipole moment? So electric dipole moment, it determines us how strong the electric dipole is. It determines the strength of the electric dipole. Okay. And if we write the electric dipole, we denote it by small p. Okay. And it is equals to what? Product of magnitude of either charges. You're having two charges here, Q and plus Q, right? So we will just take one charge, okay, its magnitude, into with the separation or the distance between them. And always remember, we take this separation between the two charges to be twice of L, 2L, okay? So this is twice of L. Clear? That's it. So if you're writing only the magnitude of this dipole, you can write P is equals to Q into it 2L. So this is the formula of electric dipole moment. Always remember, the direction of electric dipole is what? Negative to positive. It is always from negative to positive. Remember, the direction of electric field is positive to negative. Field lines go from positive to negative, but dipole moves from negative to positive. So since it has a direction negative to positive, it is a vector quantity. Clear? Now, if we are asked to calculate the dimension of dipole, so how will you calculate it? So for this, you see the formula for electric dipole. So this is the charge and this is the length. You are having charge into with the length. Okay, distance. There is a distance. So if you see, the unit of charge is coulomb, right? And the unit of length is what? Meter. Anything, right? Because 2 is constant. So if you see the formula for charge, we know current is charge per unit time. So charge is what? Current into with time. Okay. And you know, for length, the dimension is L, right? So if you write the dimension for dipole, you can write it as what? It will be, for charge, you know, current has unit A and time has T. So it is A T L. Clear? So here you will write the dimension to be A T and L. Similarly, the unit, SI unit is what? For charge, coulomb, and for length it's what? Meter. So you will have coulomb meter to be its unit. Clear? So this is about the electric dipole moment. Now you see, sometimes you might get to know ideal dipole. You might get some special cases for ideal dipole, or you can say for point dipole. Okay, if the dipole is ideal or point, what is the ideal dipole, or you can say point dipole? Suppose if q, the charge is tending to infinity, okay? And the separation between the two charges tends to zero, means the separation is almost zero, okay? In that case, the value of dipole must be finite, okay? The value of the magnitude of the charge should be tends to infinity. If the separation between them is 2L, that is, that tends to be zero, then we take the dipole to be finite, okay? Such a dipole with negligibly small size, right? Negligibly small size is said to be as ideal dipole or point dipole. You can just write when the charge tends to infinity and the separation between them tends to zero, and dipole is what? Very small, okay? It has some value, very small finite value, okay? Finite but very small. Then such a dipole is said to be ideal dipole or point dipole. Clear? So this was all about the electric dipole, electric dipole moment, and ideal dipole. In the next video, we will calculate the electric field intensity due to dipole at the axial position or end-on position. Remember, this axial position is also said to be as end-on position. Okay? Both are same. Clear? So that's all in this video. Thank you so much. Have a good day.